Hey guys, Matt here for Science or Fiction. You ever meet someone so happy that you figure they must be hiding some terrifying secrets? You know, like your coworker Brad? Ugh, nothing good could come from hanging out with someone as happy as Brad, right? Maybe I should give Brad a call. A few years back, headlines were running with the assertion that happiness may be contagious, like a bizarro awesome version of the flu. So can the happiness of others actually make you happy? Is our best hope for happiness to hang out with happy guys like Brad, who refuse to share everyone's gloom that it's only Tuesday and the work week is lasting forever? Well, the idea that happiness is contagious comes from a study that followed more than 4,700 people for 20 years and asked them to periodically fill out questionnaires about their well-being. After creating an emotional baseline, the researchers found that emotions fluctuated based on the participants' social network. And no, we're not talking about their Snapchat followers. For example, the study found that a good friend who lives about a half mile away can increase happiness up to 42%. A neighbor can increase happiness 34%. And a spouse? Well, a spouse can only increase happiness about 8%. Sorry, guys. The study found that happiness doesn't seem to spread in the workplace, however, possibly because if one person gets a promotion, well, someone else doesn't. Hey, wait a minute. Does that mean Brad got the promotion? Ugh, typical. But some people have their doubts about the study's findings, arguing that it's possible that happy people are just drawn to other happy people. It could also be that people who live near each other share the same types of environments that might increase happiness, like safe neighborhoods, affluence, or good employment. In response to these arguments, the study's authors said that strangers sharing the same environment, say an affluent, safe neighborhood, didn't have the same positive happiness effect as neighbors who knew each other, concluding that it was the who and not the where. However, detractors remain, even publishing another study based on the same data set and using the same correlation reasoning. Using those methods, they were able to find that non-transferable traits like height were also contagious. They found short teenagers who befriended tall kids actually became taller over time. Man, studies trolling other studies. It happens. Other serious research has shown that it's actually biological factors rather than societal ones that determines happiness. One such study found that 35% to 50% of happiness was attributable to genetic factors like those found in your brain, not your neighbor. In the end, the happiness contagion findings weren't as conclusive as some headlines indicated. That contagion may be more correlation and less causation, and if there is causation, well, it could also be impacted by biological factors. Now, that's not to say you can't become happy, it just means you might not have to hang out with Brad to do so. You can't stop smiling, can you? Yeah, I know. Anyway, what do you think? Not about the dark secrets Brad's probably hiding behind that cold smile. About what makes people happy. What makes you happier? Your significant other or your friends? Don't answer if your spouse is in the room, especially if she's a praying mantis. Check out this video if you don't know what I'm talking about. Don't forget to subscribe and keep coming back to Seeker for more videos.